Good morning everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to Riti Vihare and Rambadagalla Vihare. If you want to come here, you have to come to Kurunagala first, then you have to take the Kurunagala to Kandy Road. And after coming to Mallava Pitiya Junction, you have to turn left to Ridigama Town. And then onwards, it is very easy to find the road. There are boats everywhere and I'll even pin the location here. And there is a very specific and a very beautiful story about Ridhi Viharaya. So I'll tell you along the way. Let's go. As I told you before, there is a great history behind this place. This place was once used by traders as a resting place. One day, when they came here, they ate jackfruit and they saw a monk meditating in a cave. They offered some of the jackfruit to that monk, and when they went to offer the monk jackfruit, they saw a metal, a special metal, coming out of the earth. They didn't know what metal it was. So they took some of it and showed King Dutugamuno. In that period, King Dutugamuno was stuck at making the Ruwan Valley Saya stupa. He didn't have enough money. When he saw this metal, he knew that instantly this was silver. So he came here and got the silver from the earth. It was like a sprout. Metaphorically speaking, when you cut a banana tree, a small sprout comes out of the tree. Just like that, this silver has come out of earth. So with the help of the silver, King Dutugamuno had finished Ruwan Valley Saya stupa and also gave salaries to the workers as well. As a thank you, he had made a golden statue of Buddha from India and placed it here in the temple. And there are many stories, I don't know even if they are true or not. They say that the statue came itself to this place and positioned it here. And now we can see the statue here placed in the place where the silver sprout began. That is the story of Ridhi Vihara. We saw a board telling that this road leads to Pahangala and it is 800 meters only. So let's go to Pahangala. And I think this hike is totally worth it because to see this kind of a scenery, to enjoy the beauty of nature from this high, normally you need to climb much higher than this. After 800 meters hike here here we are. Let me show you the scenery. That is Batalaguda Lake. If you didn't watch the video of Batalaguda Lake, I'll pin the link up here. And if you see, this is Yagdesagala, and also here you can see Dolukanda, the two main places or mountains that we need to climb if we are in Kurunagala. This is Pahangala. I think this is about 100 meters drop from here. I hope you can see it. From here. That is where we were the last minute, and then we took the path through here and came here. Now we are at Rambadagalla Monaragala statue, and we are climbing up the rock so that we can find the statue. Telling something about the statue, this process started in 2002, and they have spent 13 years in carving the statue in the natural rock.